Hi, this is Trails, and today we have another episode of Police Chases, but I've decided to surprise you with a change of perspective, and as you probably guessed, this time I'm switching to the dark side. We'll be playing as a criminal trying to escape in an old 60s muscle car in an industrial zone. You'll see both night and day challenges. Sometimes, the number of cops is overwhelming, and the adrenaline level matches it. As always, I've turned off all driving assists. I'm using a manual transmission, clutch, pedals, a wheel, and of course, head tracking for better visibility and immersion. So here we are in what I call the Grandpa Mobile. It's not the prettiest car, but I like it. I love old cars. And to be honest, this particular car is one of my favorites in the game. It's a joy to drive. As Doug DeMuro said, the main thing is that the car makes you happy. I totally agree with him on that. This car has a lot of character. You need to get used to it. But once you do, it brings nothing but positive emotions. And I should say, this isn't even the strongest modification of it. Quite the opposite, but as practice has shown, its power is more than enough if you use it skillfully. Yes, it slides a bit, and driving it feels like steering a boat, really, but that just makes it more fun. So, on one side, there's me as the criminal, and on the other, the entire state police. Let's see who wins. And keep in mind, the Grandpa Mobile isn't that fast, and it sways like a drunken deer. But in full manual mode, it's an amazing car. A bit lazy in corners, but it's still full of life. Subscribe, and I'd appreciate your likes. I ended up with a lot of material from this scenario. So I had to split the footage into three parts. If you want to watch the second and third parts of these chases, right now on your screens in the top right corner, you have the option to jump to the other videos in this series. Finally, I want to draw your attention to the fact that with the in-cabin view, you can track the progress of catching the offender. Just pay attention to the widget located in the top right part of the screen. It contains all the information, the pursuit level displayed with icons, an indication of whether the criminal is in the police's line of sight, progress information on catching the offender, chase time, and the number of police units involved in the chase. So all the information is right before your eyes, and I'll be silent now. Enjoy your viewing. I've put a lot of effort into these chases. I love chasing, but editing, especially non-linear editing, is not for the faint-hearted, especially if you're not used to it. So I would appreciate any support from you, whether it's likes, subscriptions, or if you share these videos with your friends. And of course, I would be over the moon if you do all of that at once. Well, this was Trails. I wish you a great day, take care, and see you next time.